Well, it seems like on so many of our trips, we pound it and pound it and pound it and finally have some success at the end. I'm so used to that, and it's kind of built us, and it's kind of defined who we are. Just work and work and never stop.
That's definitely a shark. I don't know how big it was, but it was definitely a shark.
But within the first couple hours, we already had a shark.
Yeah, there he is. Little one. Okay, here he comes. He's going to come right in on it. Got it. Start him up. Yeah, start him up. Nice job, boys.
Shark came in on our seal decoy again, and it swam around for a little while, and then it picked up a bait.
This time, you know, after months of looking and planning at the charts, came right into one spot.
Make sure your trim tabs are up, Chris.
Trim tabs. We showed up and we started. Have an action of catching sharks right away, which really takes the pressure off.
Get it, let it go, Brett. Up.
I don't see any parasites in the mouth.
We can get, we got some parasites on the dorsal fin here if anybody wants to grab some of those.
I don't see any scars.
Yes, everything's going smooth. We got about 5 or 6 more minutes to get our final procedure done here, and we're gonna let this beautiful 13-foot white shark go, female. All right, we're gonna name this beautiful female shark Gray Lady. For all the people in Nantucket who've given us such amazing hospitality, they have their own shark now to follow. There you go, girl, kicking right away. I like to see that. We are grateful for all you've done for us, Nantucket, so here is your female white shark, Gray Lady. Get her going, girl, good luck.
When you're doing stuff like this, one shark really makes a whole expedition, and to have it happen on the first day, wow, really makes you feel like, you know, you don't really know what's going to happen. And if you can get a jump start like this and maybe pick off a couple extra sharks, talking about learning what we've never learned before at a rate that's never been achieved.